time to learn about Procreate interface. Hey everyone, I'm Harini. I make videos weekly on digital art, stickers, digital planning tutorials, and getting creative digitally. Going digital has its own drawbacks though, like the struggles facing by the beginners to learn Procreate. So hopefully this video will help you in reducing or eliminating such struggles in understanding Procreate interface. This video will likely be more helpful to all Procreate beginners. So if you are someone who just purchased a Procreate that's really struggling, this video likely would solve that problem. Unfortunately, I can't show you everything in a single video, so we are going to have a series on this. The series is easy to follow even for complete beginners. To get best out of this series, you need to practice what you see in the videos immediately by following them step by step. Don't go to the next series until you have practiced the current one. In the series, I will show you how to use Procreate app. We will discover the app interface, the basic tools, and some advanced techniques that you will use to create a beautiful illustration. Also, during the video, we will create a solar system illustrations, which will be your first big accomplishment in using Procreate app. Try not to skip any series in order to make sure that you get familiar with all the tools that I use in my drawing process. So you will be able to gain the skills quickly that I've developed through years of practice. Before I continue with the video, make sure to subscribe to my channel as it motivates me to continue with my work. Now let's continue with the video. Download Procreate app from App Store. Prepare your Apple Pencil and let's get started. What you will learn in the first series, how to import files and photos, how to duplicate a file, rename a file, delete a file, create a stack with many files, rename a stack. Let's begin with the Procreate app for the first time by clicking on it. This is the main gallery screen with all the artwork we have. Right now, we see some demo illustrations that we get when we install the app. If we click the gallery button here, we can get back to the main screen. We can click any artwork to open it. Open this file and go back again. Now let's see what we can do with these files. We can swipe left on any file to open the options menu. Here you can quickly share, duplicate or delete the file. Let's duplicate it now. It has the same name as the original file, so let's rename it. Click on this title and here we can type our rename with any new name. I will rename it now. Now let's delete this file, same as before. Swipe left and click delete. Delete, done. When time goes by, we will get a lot of files and it can start looking really uncluttered here. There is a best way to organize your files by grouping them into folders that are called stacks in Procreate. To make a stack, just drag one file on the top of the other file. They are grouping the stacks now. Click on it to get inside the stacks. You can see our two files here. Also, you can rearrange order the files by clicking and dragging them like this. Click the back button. Let's add another file to the stack. Drag the file on the top of the stack. Wait a bit and drop it into the desired place of the stack. Click and drag the file to the back button. Wait a bit, drop it on the main gallery screen. To remove the stack, we need to take out all the files from the inside. Now let's try the faster way of taking out multiple files at the same time. Click select here. It enables us to select the multiple files. Click on each file. As you can see here, we can perform the group action here on the selected files. Click on stack, it's done. Click on the cross here, let's rename the stack. For example, let's call sample photos. And as you can see, all of our files are inside these stacks. Go back. Also, if you click import, we can import other files into gallery. Click import. That opens up the files folder here.
Here we can import files from our iCloud storage or import our downloaded files. It is especially useful if you work in Procreate on multiple devices. And the last but is the photo button. It will let you import photos from your iPad gallery. Click photo, that opens up our photo gallery. Select any photo to use it as reference for you to begin with your contour. So I hope you enjoyed today's video and that you feel inspired to getting started with Procreate on your own. If you liked this video, you may like some of my other videos where I cover a lot more ways to design and paint on your iPad, like how to create illustrations and animation, how to create digital sticker and other tutorials. Check this out on my YouTube profile if you want to see more. And if you want to get a notification every time I publish a new video, click the bell icon at the bottom. Also, I share a lot of free downloads on my website. If you want to get more downloads like the Procreate working file, brushes, color palette, check out my site. And link mentioned below in the description. I would absolutely love if you share your progress that on comment section. So share that. If you have any question about the process you learned in this video, please feel free to reach out to me, or you could reach out to me through my website. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again next time. Bye bye.